Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. This is Mir Muntazir. And today we are going to discuss the future perfect tense. The future perfect tense refers to a completed action in the future. When we use this tense, we are projecting ourselves forward into the future and looking back at an action that will completed sometime later there. And it is often used with a time expression. Like, I will give an example. Ali will have cooked the food before you arrive. Now, let's look the structure of future perfect tense. It has very simple structure. For the structure for positive sentences is subject plus will have or shall have plus verb's third form, or you can say the past participle, in short PP plus object. Like, I will give an example. I shall have reached there tomorrow evening. I shall have reached there tomorrow evening. Reached is the third form, the past form of reach, past participle form of reach. So you have to remember the structure for positive sentences, that is subject plus will have or shall have plus past participle of verb plus object. And for negative sentences, subject plus will not have or shall not have plus verb's third form. Like, I shall not have finished my work till tomorrow. I shall not have finished my work till tomorrow. And for interrogative sentences, the structure is shall or will plus subject plus have plus verb's third form plus object. Like, will you have gone to school before they reach there? And at the end of the sentence, put question mark. So this is all about the future perfect tense. Now move to future perfect continuous tense. The future perfect continuous tense describes an ongoing action that will be completed at a specified time in the future. And this tense, the future perfect continuous, is typically used with an expression specifying a future time, like, I shall have been sleeping for an hour when you will come to see me. Or it is used with an expression stating the length of the activity. The length of the activity. Like, on Monday, Ali will have been living on the island for a month. So here it is the length of the activity or length of the action. I repeat once again the example. On Monday, Ali will have been living on the island for a month. Now let's look the structure for positive sentences, that is subject plus will have been or shall have been plus verb's base form plus ing plus object and since and for. Here you have to remember one thing. In future perfect tense, we use the past participle form of verb. And in future perfect continuous, we use the present participle. That is the verb's base form, or you can see the verb's first form plus ing. Like, I will give an example. They will have been running for an hour. Here I use for because here is the duration of time. I repeat once again the structure. Subject plus will have been or shall have been plus verbs base form plus ing plus object plus since or for. And where to use since and where to use for, I have already discussed it in my previous videos. You can check it. And for negative sentences, the structure is subject plus will or shall plus not have been plus verbs base form plus ing plus object. Like, I will make the negative of the same sentence, that is, they will not have been running for an hour. And for interrogative sentences, the structure is will or shall plus subject plus have been plus verbs base form plus ing plus object. Like, will they have been running for an hour? So this is all about the future perfect continuous. And by this we have completed our topic, that was tenses.